For many years, there's been a common understanding that men and women experience stroke the same way. But there's been recent evidence showing that women actually present to hospital with stroke differently than men. And more specifically, women might come into hospital having speech and language problems, visual symptoms, or even swallowing difficulties, whereas men may come into hospital with weakness or numbness on one side. It's important to recognize these symptoms so that when you're aware, you go immediately to the hospital and be treated for stroke. My particular research at the George Institute is looking at sex differences in stroke management and outcome. We want to find out if people are treated differently when they come into hospital while having a stroke and when they're followed up in the community. We also want to find out how they do after their stroke. So we want to find out if women are living more in nursing homes or are they independent in their own homes. And finally, we want to look at whether there are biological differences in stroke between men and women. And in particular, we want to look at CT and MRI images and see if there's a difference there. Our preliminary findings show that women are older when they have strokes, they have more severe strokes, they experience more disability after strokes, and death rate is also higher after stroke. So the George Institute recently established a global women's health program under the leadership of Professor Robin Norton. Sex and gender research is important because it may inform us on risk factor control as well as therapeutic interventions. When there's awareness, then you can create solutions into these problems.